So let's start with a brief intro about this session, right? What we are going to discuss. Okay. The session would be how we maintain state, right? And when we say state, so it's necessary to keep that information on client side sometime. Okay. The use case is, though the principle is like a single source of truth, we want to maintain one single source of truth so that every component or whatever element you have on UI, they can rely on that source only. Okay. And there could be a number of sources who are pushing information into this store. Okay. So the concept is maintaining that information on client side somehow, and implementation of this single source of truth with the help of this NGRX, okay, with the Angular application. So there are multiple ways to handle it, but here we are using the library NGRX, right, with the help of RxJS even, okay, so that the information that is mandatory or necessary for UI to render the component and the information that we are maintaining on a client side. Client side means the browser side. Okay. So this is overall gist. Okay. And there are multiple ways of doing it. We are using just this library this time. Okay. There are other libraries as well, like ng-access as well. Akita is already there. Okay. But this is the library that we generally choose for Angular development. Okay. In most of the cases. Okay. So now Paras and Alka will explain you in detail. Okay. Maybe I can take a back seat now. And Paras, you can take over.
Yeah, thank you, Neeraj. Thank you so much. So now we can start the session and move forward towards the detail what about the NGRXs or the Angular State Management. So guys, I'm sharing my screen first of all, so you can take a view how we can go. My screen is visible to all.
Yes,
Is anyone?
yes,
Yeah.
yes, sir.
Thank you, Alka. Thank you, Nires. So first of all, our topic for the day is Angular State Management, and we can done it by NGRX. It is a reactive library which perform a reactive approach for our Angular application, and we also take a brief look about it in our next slides. So moving forward, let us take first of all, of our knowledge etiquettes like punctuality. We have to respect our knowledge session on time, join the knowledge session before the start of 5 minute threshold. We have always give a constructive feedback because it is very helpful for the presenter. Please keep your mobile devices in silent mode and feel free move out to the session in case of any urgency or any urgent meeting. Also avoid disturbance or unwanted chit-chat during the session. So moving forward, so to our agenda for today's session, and these are some important points we have to take look into it. First, introduction about NGRX. The second one, what is NGRX store? The third one is NGRX and Redux, how it is working. The fourth, using store states, what about action reducer in NGRX? Like we take a look what is reducer, what is states, what are action done in NGRX, or how it can perform the complete overview. And last but not the least, we can take a look into the DAB. So moving forward, we take a very important look, as Neeraj said, the key feature, why NGRX, the single source of truth. So it is a very important before starting the topic, like we always fetch our data in some sense in any application in our Angular. So we can say that the fetching of data in an Angular application can be done by many ways. It will be a HTTP request, an asynchronous request from the server. But we all have always difficult to manipulate that data which we get from the API request. So to solve this problem, we implemented NGRX store, or simply NGRX. This NGRX allow us to manage all the states with the help of store. We always manipulate the new states and store them in our store. So also the different state present in NGRX store are always immutable. We do not mutate it once our action is performed. The only the states are changed when a certain type of action is performed. So we can say by simply take a look at the end, we can collect data from sources and save that data in the store. And after that, we can do what we think we want to do with that particular data, like update the data, increment the value, decrement the value, multiplying the value, and sort of things or different types of action. So this is a single source of truth about NGRX, why we use. So moving towards next, is there any doubt? So I will take it as a no. So moving forward, let's talk about what is Angular State Manager, because it is also important to know. Like backend application have databases to store and manage state for any application in data in backend. But the frontend have need some sort of type of mechanism to handle that part. So NGRX comes into play. Once again, the data ranges from response got an HTTP request to form input and user routes. So these all sorts of data we can manipulate by the help of NGRX in an Angular application. So it is always a good practice to compose all of your data in a central state, which is named as store, for easy management and data communication. So for this, we can use Angular State Management, and the Angular State Management provide a single way of communication to a particular Angular application. We can fetch any part of data through the communication channel in any component of the Angular application. So this is the main goal of the Angular State Management. Like, we can make a single channel of communication all over the application, and we can communicate these types of data in any component or any sub part of the component or any root part of the component. So we can communicate all over the application. Moving towards next, like, first of all, take a basic look about the introduction to NGRX. NGRX is a group of Angular libraries which have reactive approach to do something in an Angular application. So these are completely made up of reactive extensions and state management. It makes the Angular development easier by simplifying the application state in different objects and enforcing a unidirectional flow throughout the application. It manages the system should enable to model a state. Like, I provided a single example over here. We can create a single representation or a simple representation of an Angular application. After that, we can update the value, change the value, increment the value, and store it in the, save that value in the store. So this is the basic part of the NGRX. Like, we have an old state in store and we have a new state in store. So basically, store handles both the states, and we can update state by performing different actions. Always the new states will save in the store, and so on. After that, we perform different types sort of actions over the new state also. So this is about the basic look about the NGRX. Moving towards the next, these are some of sort of libraries where NGRX works. First is managing global and local state of an Angular application or any type of application. Isolation of side effects to promote a clear component architecture. It is a very important point that we always want our application to be a architecture based with a simple architecture, means we know every root component or the leaf component, the complete flow of our application, so it isolates the side effects also. The third important point here is entity collection management. The fourth one is integration with the Angular route, means it also enhances the routing of the Angular application. The last but not least here, developer tooling that enhances developer experience. It also increases the developer experience while building an Angular application. We talk about basically Angular application because we have implemented in that part. So is there any question? Anybody?
No, Paras, you can continue.
Yeah, thank you, Saurabh. So moving towards next part, there are some sort of packages provided by the NGRX in an Angular application, and these are some of main categories also. Like here in this slide, the state is the main category, but store, effect, router store, entity, and component store are the subpart of that category. So these subparts have their own important characteristics, like store, RxJS powered global state management for an Angular app inspired by Redux. Basically, it is work like Redux works. The effects, it applied end to end, means once we perform the action, the effect works and updated the value immediately. There is no lack of seconds. Router store, binding to connect the Angular routes with the NGRX store, means we can navigate to other component, the update, we can get the updated value in the next component. Like I can say an example that in component A, I update an increment action. So I updated the previous value to 40. So I route to the other component of the same application. So because of the router store, we get the updated value in the component where we routed. Means we can get the updated value in the component B also. So the fourth one is entity. That is entity state adapter for managing records collection, like what are the actions we perform, what are the actions reducer makes, and that's all. Like the fifth one is component store, that is standalone library for managing all local component states. Means that it is a component store, basically it manages all the local states of a particular component. While we perform different action in a single component, like say in the same component, we incremented the value, we multiply the value, we store the value, we reset the value. So the component store standalone collects all the data, manage all the data for that particular state. We can also mention a point previously and in this slide also, that all these states are immutable in nature. We cannot mutate them. So moving towards the next main categories of the NGRX packages, these are data, that is extensions for simplified entity data management. The view, it is simply similar to the component, like extension for fully reactive Angular application. The developer tooling is also important because there are two points. First is store dev tools, then second is semantics. We can work with the semantic also, that is scaffolding library for Angular application using NGRX libraries. So about these all overview, but in this session, we mainly focus about the store libraries because it is a very important to know how they work. Especially we will demonstrate in the demo also how store will work, how store will show, how store will make, what are actions, what are reducer belonging to the store. So moving towards the next, we take a look about NGRX store. So is there any question? So I will take it as a no and moving toward. I am audible, guys. Anyone?
Yes,
Paras. Yeah, Paras, you are audible.
Thank you, guys. Moving towards the next, we take a look about the NGRX store. So NGRX store is Redux inspired state management system. Basically, it is Redux inspired because it is very reactive in nature. So we can say that it is Redux inspired, or it is a sort of reactive extensions like that part. So it is Redux inspired state management system that enable us to observe and manage the state in an Angular application. Like we observe the state, the previous state, the new state, or we can say the updated state. So we observe all the states and we manage them according to the updation. Like a state one is a older, we perform certain action, so then state two is the newer state. So we can manage the state by the help of NGRX store, which save all the states in itself. So we can also control state container design, help to write performant consistent application on the top of Angular. We can modify also this NGRX store in some cases, but we can go through the primary advantage first. What is about what are the primary advantage provided by the Angular NGRX store to an Angular application? So these are ability to store the states in a single tree that is accessible from any part of the application. It is a very important point that we store all the state in a central part that we call named as store, and it is a single tree. This tree is accessible throughout the application, means we can access any type of state or any state, new state, previous state from any part of our application. So it is also mainly managing global state across the entire application. We can also access the local states for temporary component, for local component, using the NGRX component store. As we previously mentioned, that the NGRX component store manages the all local state for a local component or a temporary component like that. So moving towards next, what are NGRX and how it is work with Redux? So NGRX consists of three main parts, that is store, action and reducer. The store, action and reducer are the three things on the basis the NGRX works. The store is a central area which save all the states of the application. The action are sort of things which we have to perform in an application, like incrementing a function. I'm saying that these incrementing, decrementing, because these are simple. We have a simple sort of action in mind that if we say word increment, we basically increment a value. We say multiply, we basically multiply a value. So we can get easily what things we are doing. So actions are sort of things that like incrementing a value, multiplying a value, decrementing a value. Updated value, we can say that we can decrement it, updated value. And reducers are the tie which connect action and store. When an action is called or dispatched, the reducer works, collect the details, perform the particular action and update the store according to the updated state. So reducers are very important while working in NGRX, and we know how it is work. It is very important to know. So moving forward about all these things, we can take a look in the diagram. We already talked about previously, but throughout the diagram, we can take it as a basic scenario. Like we are in a component and dispatch an action A, that is multiplying a value and the previous value is 0 or 1. Like we take a previous value is 1. So while we dispatching an action, the reducer collects the old state, that is 1, multiply that part and store the new state value in the store. Or we can say that the reducer collects the old state value, multiply with action what we have to perform, and save that new value in the new state in the store. So this diagram is simply says that. Moving towards next, we take out look how the store states. These are object key value pair that holds the data. So in the figure, as you see, we have a person having key value pair of name. First is Wisdom Ekpot and the second name is John Cat. So this is a state of store where the data is saved in our Angular application. So moving towards next, that is define action. We define an action as our methods dispatched by the component when an event is triggered or dispatched. Here you can define a type and also a payload it will be sending. So I am defining a type as change name. It is basically the action name which we have to perform. Like we have changed the name, we have deleted the name, we have updated the name, like that. And we also pass a payload, as you see in the image, with the key value pair of name, and here name is wisdom. So we can pass a key value pair, we can say the payload or the type in the action method. So moving towards next, here's the reducer. It is called when an action is dispatched, and it is very important part. To create reducer method, we handle the state transitions. To access the state, we have to import the initial state, or we can say the previous state, into the reducer file. Okay. To trigger an action, we use the event we have to perform. What type of action we have to perform, like update the value, delete the value, or increment or decrement the value. So we take the name of the action as a parameter and update the value and save that value in the store. So these are the three things which a NGRX store will use, that is action, the second one is store, and the third one is reducer. All these three things are integrated with each other. So it is very important to know, and I think I'm clear about this. So is there any question till now, or we move to the further part? Anyone?
No, Paras.
Is guys an audible?
Yeah, you are.
Yeah. So I will take it as a no and moving towards the next part, that is our demo. So we can take a look about all the NGRX, how it is working, how the code will write. So first of all, we look at the demo part. So I have already run that part. So this is our NGRX store basically. I also open the Redux. So because of that, we will look. So you can see on the right hand side, if I multiply this value by 2, so shown here, and no. The value updated, and I can see that updated. So see that on the county.
Sorry to interrupt you, Paras, but we are not getting your voice.
Hello, Saurabh, I'm audible now. Hello.
Yeah, Paras, you are. Yeah.
Thank you, Saurabh. Thank you. So we can take a look at. So I can restart. No problem, guys. So on the right hand side, you can see the counters. What are the action we run? So these buttons are the sort of action which we have to perform, like increment by 2, multiply by 2, divide by 2, and store the value. So these are sort of actions which we have to perform. So this is the updated count. Once we perform an action, the updated count is shown here and the storage remains same, but it will change once we store the data or the value. So I simply increment this value by 2. So once I increment the value, the previous value will be 1, but after the increment by 2, the updated count will be 3. And also on the right hand side, you see that the values incremented by 2. That's the counter says. Also, we can perform a different action on the updated value, like we have multiplied the value by 2 and it will update the count to 6. And we can see that there is a multiply counter will perform. Like if we want to decrement a value, so it will decrement value by 1. So once I click, it will decrement value by 1. That is updated count will be 5, and you can see that either counter, the decrement counter will perform. These are the sort of action which we have performed. So once we store the value, like I perform an action to store that value and I'm clicking that. So the store counter will work and now I'm refresh my page. So the updated value will be stored at that storage. So you can see that once I refresh the value, the updated value store at here. So this all are work done by NGRX. So is there any doubt? Anyone? How this is working? We can take a look to the code base also. So is there any doubt to anyone till now that how the action will working, how the... Hello? Hello, I am audible?
Yeah.
Yes, Paris, you are audible.
Yeah. So is there any doubt anyone how the actions are performed, how reducers are working? So I will take it as a no. So so we will move towards the code, how they will work. So yeah. So first of all, we take a look at the actions. So here is the part of our projects, the workflow or the directory structure. We can say that we have made the select reducers, effects, and the actions. So over actions, we create our action file, that is counteraction.ts, in which we define different types of actions. And in the effect.ts file, we define our effect, how the storage will get works, how the store will work, how the count will get by the store. In the reducer part, we will take a look. It is a very important. It will take the previous state, get the count, updated the state, and save the data in the store. So we will take a look about that also. So now, first of all, take a look about the actions. So so these are sort of actions which we created, like increment by 2, decrement, multiply, divide, and store count. So these are the action created, and we can create by creating them an action method. So in action method, we pass 2 parameters. First is payload, the second one is type. As you see in the store counter action, we passes 2 parameters. First is type and second is other payload, that is props. But in our increment decrement actions, we pass only the type, and it consists of the name, what type of action we have to perform. If there is a similar name of 2 actions, the app will not work, because it is mandatory to always provide a different action to a single button or a scroll or something else. So this is about the action. Now let us take about the important part, that is reducer. So it is also, it is integrated with the action and store. So once an action is triggered or a dispatch, the reducer will first encounter it, and it take a look which action is called or dispatched. Like once we click on the increment button, the reducer check that the increment action is performed, and it will take the state, get the count, and perform the increment of the value, update, and make a complete new state. Because of that, we can say that the new states are immutable. So this will get the new state, and this value will save in our store. So this is, I'm like to say, these are the different reducers we make for the different actions. Also, there are sort of things which we have to look. We have to always import actions in the reducer, and in actions we always add the create action method from the NGRX store. We can also take a look about the effects files. This is also a very important part. After the reducer works, it triggers the effects to get the count and store the value as a new state in the store. It disabled the old value from the store and provide a new state to the store. So I think this is all about the NGRX part. So I will move back to the demo. So till now, is there any question? Anyone?
No, Paras.
So I think all guys understand about complete the NGRX store. Guys,
is this solution working?
Yes, Dheeraj, this solution is working.
Okay, so fine. So are you done with the session or do you still have?
Yeah, I think I'm done with the demo and the presentation. If the guys have any doubt, they can ask, because we have about 10 or 7 to 8 minutes.
Okay, to summarize,
you have the time, Paras, because we don't have any other knowledge planned after this.
Yeah.
Okay,
Kent in the chat is asking client number or such thing, what are the limitations? Like, I can give the answer about that. What are the limitations? There are sort of limitations like that according to our workflow. Sometimes
Okay, so let me answer. I'm audible now because I'm facing some network issue.
Yeah, Neera, sorry, there is a voice.
And so, are you getting me properly?
Yes,
Neeraj, you are audible.
Okay, so one question I see, client number or such thing. The store is meant for, let's say, single page application. Okay, so most probably you'll be using the store mechanism for one application, right? But there are certain other ways, like if you want to share the store, okay, but those are workaround only. So ideally the information would be limited to one application, but dynamically you can play with this store. You can let's say keep some persistence, right, with this store. You can store these values somewhere else, like session storage or local storage, and try to access those variable and try to convert those object to another, another store that would be related to another application. But those all are workaround, right? There is no direct way of doing it, right, with this store. And store means we are maintaining some information related to that application only, right? And maybe there might be some other thing, like you can bootstrap your application again and again with the same store. That could be one another solution, right? But as I said, like, there is no direct way of doing it, whatever this framework says. But yes, there are always possibility with the JavaScript, because JavaScript is quite flexible. You can write your own script, you can inject your own module, okay? Through module sharing, you can also achieve this, right? If you go into more details, right? Those are certain things that store mechanism says, single source of truth, as I mentioned, right? So we should be consistent, consistently, and we should maintain the store concurrency and consistency during these operations. Because there could be a number of sources to update the store. Let's say one scenario could be you are fetching data from backend using HTTP calls. There could be another scenario, like this is one mechanism, you are pulling a data from backend. There could be another way. I mean, some services or maybe WebSocket is pushing some data or information to your store. Now you need not to bother about how many sources are pushing or pulling data to this store. But for your UI, this is the single source of truth. You will always hook your object from this store, the components that you have, right? As you know, Angular is heavily based on observable pattern. So most of the object that you will be dealing on your UI, they will, those object will be subscribing to some services or some object. And now in this case, store is that place. Okay. So you will always subscribe to your store object, and then you can rely whatever information is available with store. That is truthful. That is live or real time, I can say, right? So this is overall gist, right? So user, as a user, when you have a UI, you will invoke some action, and this action is now the state action, whatever I say, store action, okay? Based on this action, there'll be certain effects. I mean, the side effect of those actions, okay? And when there are some effects, you will again try to modify your store, because you want to keep that data in a consistent and concurrent way, so that there should not be any leakage in data, and that should look like real time. Okay, I see answer from Kent. It would be nice to share the store state for different app to have an interaction between several app. I'm looking for those workaround. Okay, maybe okay. So maybe with this session, we can paste some link. You can follow those one if that works for you. And we'll try to, let's say, also, I see you want this example to be pushed somewhere. Okay. Maybe we can share a GitHub link with you. Parash, you can push this solution to some GitHub space in terms of TechUp template. We are already using that mechanism. Okay. Kent, you can keep following our TechUp space. Okay. There are a number of templates that you can utilize for your development, right? And yeah, we'll try to serve you better. Okay.
Yeah, Neeraj, we have provide. I'm sharing it as a TechUp template.
Mm-hmm.
So I will share with the Kent also. Kent will take it as in our knowledge TechUp portal and also from our front end LinkedIn page.
Yeah, LinkedIn page is also there. And what I'll suggest, just add one slide, okay, on top of this. And in that slide, mention the GitHub link and some, let's say, reference link, so that Kent can get the help.
Sure, Neeraj.
Right?
Yeah.
Will that be okay, Kent? Yeah, I got a response. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. Any other question, guys? Okay, we are on time, I think, guys. Thanks for joining, everyone, including Kent. And yeah. We'll see you soon again, hopefully.
Yeah, guys, thanks for joining the session. If there are any doubt in future, you can ping us to Frontend Studio and also ping us on our LinkedIn page.
Yeah, and that will mention in the last slide, right, Paras?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for joining this session.
Thank you all. Thank you, Paras. Thank you, Neeraj. And thanks, everyone. Have a good and great day ahead.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.